Y'all be sure and thank the Lions Club tonight. This is probably their last night here. They're going to be moving to a new building, and this is going to be the new City Hall.
I'm Dick Peterson, and I'm retired, and I have a retro boomer DJ service where I play old-timey record players and old-timey records for free at senior centers and community centers and nonprofits. I went to a party, and the guy had a bunch of old 78s. And I said, well, how did you do this? And he said, well, I got on the internet and I bought me an old Caliphone record player that came from a high school, and I use it to play my old 78 collection. And I says, well, what do they pay you? And he said, nothing. And I said, well, that sounds like fun. I've been paid nothing before. So I got on the internet and I bought me a couple of old Caliphone record players, and I've got them linked together. And when I'm doing a job for hire, like a wedding or a high school reunion or something like that, I have a Panasonic linear drive turntable that I use for other people's records. That's a nicer, old-timey, programmable record player. So I can program it to pick up any track that they want, and I use that for other people's records. Whereas these old ones, you know, they measure needles and the weight on here is probably in pounds, you know, it's not in ounces. So they do track pretty well, but they're probably scratching a new groove every time I play it. I go get some records at Goodwill or Salvation Army, or Half Price Books has a quarter album section down at the bottom. Usually you gotta get real low down and get on one of those rolling stools and you can find some 25 cent albums. I've been on the Manor Planning Commission. I'm on the Travis County MUD number 2. I'm vice president of that now. I'm secretary of the Chamber of Commerce, and I'm running for the Blue Bonnet Board of Directors. So my wife says, when are you gonna retire? You know, I'm retired from Austin Energy Green Building. She says, you know, you had more time at home when you were working, you know. So now that I'm retired, I don't spend much time at home. This is the third time I've done it for the Lions Club, and I think this probably is the last time for them to do it at this location. They're selling this building to the city of Manor. It's going to become the new city hall. The old city hall is going to become the police headquarters. And then where Manor used to have a sewer plant, they're going to trade the Lions Club, if it all works out, over on old Highway 20 behind the school, New Tech High School, and that's where the new Lions Club will be built. Probably smaller, a little bit different design, but that's where they'll be doing their fish fries after a while. Yes, it's a lot of outside space, so we think we can do Manor Fest, and that's held in conjunction with the Chamber of Commerce and the Lions Club. They've worked together for the last couple of years on Manor Fest, and it's been very successful. We'll probably still do the parade downtown and just take the parade down to the new location. It was a huge success, yeah. And even though it was very cold, you know, I about froze out there, but a lot of kids riding little fake horses and riding hand car trains. Then that brings back the old time for me when I remember old Austin doing these hand cars in our track, and kids just loved it. Kids just loved it. Manor is getting ready to pop. When I moved here 5 years ago, it was getting ready to pop then too. But everybody had a little hiccup in the, you know, growth. But we're poised right now to just explode. And I used to be asked, you know, where's Manor? Well, now all I'm going to have to tell people, well, it's at the end of the Manor Expressway. You know, the Manor Expressway goes to Manor, and so they'll know where that is now. And we're going to do all right. It's been a little while coming, but I think we're going to be probably experience some of the same kind of growth as Hutto did or Kyle did. There's just not that much land around Austin, and we've got it. We've got a lot of land out here.
Not much more water left on the other side of town either.
Not much more water, and we're pretty much getting some of our water situation settled here. I live in Shadow Glen, and we've got a 20-year contract for our water, and it comes from about 50 miles away, and the wells are so deep that when it comes out of the ground, it's so hot, we got to cool that water down before we can put it in the pipes to get it to go to the houses. So,
did not know that.
Yeah, it's deep, deep water. But it's very good. We're all selling our water softeners. We have the softest water around now in Shadow Glen, so we don't have to have our water softeners anymore. You want to buy a water softener? I'm going to put mine on Craigslist. So, or maybe on your classifieds. That's what I need to do. There's a classified area. Yeah.
So, tell me about the Blue Bonnet Board.
Blue Bonnet Board of Directors. This is the third time I've been through a nominating committee process, and my qualifications are based on water conservation and electric conservation. And most people don't realize that by conserving water, you also conserve electricity, and that electric power plants are some of the biggest users of water. So we've got to think of that conservation ethic. And I'm trying to make that a very positive part of my visiting with folks and talking to them. I was with Austin Energy Green Building. I was the Xeriscape program coordinator for the city of Austin for 5 years. I developed their rainwater harvesting rebate programs. So from a background standpoint, I can really talk people about conservation and maybe even landscaping. So I become a resource if I'm on that board, and a phone will probably ring off the wall. But it's a good organization. They're gonna have their trying times too. But the wildfires have been real devastating, but it does show that, you know, after the wildfires and after the drought, we get the floods, and that's what we get here in Texas. And it washed out roads in the parks and that sort of thing, and that's the same thing that's happening to people's yards. You know, if you don't replant the grass or do something with it, well, it's going to wash away. So we're all learning. I've been a teacher for a while, so I'll have some fun teaching.
Go through it.
My